Moving on to the next part of our event, which is an inspirational story. Moving on to the next part of our event, which is an inspirational story by Mr. Ashwath Narayan, who is India's first gold medal winner at World Skills 2019, held at Kazan, Russia. Ashwath represented the country in water technology skill competition. We are really glad to have you with us today, Mr. Ashwath. Over to you, Mr. Ashwath.
Hello all, good evening. I'm here to share my journey at World Skills competition, my journey of winning the first gold medal for India. So, thank you for inviting me for the talk, first of all. So starting with how it all began from the beginning, like since I was a kid, I was always fascinated by the technology around me, and it has motivated me to think differently. And I have always been a practical learner. So this interest of mine has led me to opt engineering as my career. So I have completed my engineering in applied electronics and instrumentation. So when I was in engineering, I was always exploring what and all are the possibilities related to my core field. So I have been mostly focusing on the industrial automation as my background, being instrumentation. So I have explored what and all opportunities have come to me. But when it comes to the campaigning that has been done by the NSTC for the national competition, I have noticed that there's a big competition that's going to come up, and I have registered myself in the skill water technology, because that particular skill had automation as one of the core modules, and that being the, and I was eligible to take part in that particular skill. So then after I started training for the national competition, and I had to go through a lot of other things, because this skill, particularly being a multidisciplinary one, water technology has also been introduced at World Skills Kazan for the first time, that is in 2019, as an official skill. So there was minimal support of the documentation about the skill and all. So I had to go through other disciplines in the skill, like chemical and biological analysis of water samples, and mechanical module, wherein we had to deal with the pumps and all the pipings and fixtures in a water supply environment. So that being the case, I have done a lot of research, being from a different background, and then I prepared myself for the national competition. And in the national competition, which was held in October 2018, I have won the gold medal in this particular skill. And at that point, I thought, okay, this is something that doesn't come as an opportunity for everyone, representing India at a global platform. And looking at the scale of the competition, this particular competition is termed as the Olympics of Skills. And India has been participating since 2009. And I have decided that this is something I'm going to devote my full time to, irrespective of other things, from the pressure from the academics. Being a final year student, when I won the gold medal, I had to go through a lot of academic pressure, and also the placement scenario being the case. I didn't want to do a job in IT sector, and I wanted to stick to my core. So I thought this is something which would open doors in that way. And for me, it has helped a lot. Training for World Skills terms it as training and qualifying to compete at World Skills is equal to 4 to 5 years of professional training. And that's where I thought I'll be focusing on this. And then after winning the competition, I trained for almost a year for the competition. And in the course of time, I have also visited Germany for the international bootcamp training, wherein I got to know what exactly is the scope of this skill in the competition, because there has been minimal amount of technical documentation available, because the skill was not an official skill in the previous competitions. In the bootcamp training, I have also got to meet other people from across the globe and got to interact and see what are the areas where I need to improve, and that has given me a broader picture. And then after coming back to India, I started training, and by then I have graduated actually. So I had to completely leave everything apart, and I've completely focused on training for this competition. And it was almost 5 months of full-time training, every day, day in, day out. So I used to train in my college. My college has institute has particularly supported me to train for the competition at the Center of Excellence, which was set up in our institute itself. So I was allowed to access all the equipment, and there was a huge investment as well for my training that has been supported by my institute. So looking at different challenges that I had, for me as a student, it has always been important to look at those opportunities wherein we can enhance our knowledge basically, and try to pursue a career of our choice rather than just going about the flow. So that's where I felt that has been the driving force in the entire journey, and my family has also been a big support. And coming back to the graph of the competition, like I would like to share a screen so that I can show, if I'm allowed to do so, so that I can, excuse me.
You can go ahead, Ashwath.
Okay. Hello.
Yeah.
I'm unable to share the screen, Manu.
Did you press the share screen button?
Yes,
below?
Yes. It has been disabled.
So. All right. Just give me one second.
I'll carry on with the talk. And with the competition, so we reached Kazan, the entire Indian contingent. We were participating in, we were representing in 44 skills at the competition. The entire environment was really intense with the competition, like the scale of the competition, how they were doing it. It was very intense, and
you can share now, Ashwath.
Yes, I am.
Yeah, Shweta, we can see your screen now.
Yeah, so with the journey map of the competition, it's basically like this. So wherein we start off with the district level competitions, and then the state level, and then the regional level, and then the nationals. And then after, again, they would be selecting one of the competitor who would be representing India at World Skills competition. So actually, this is very important to see that without the kind of intensive campaign that has been done by NSTC and World Skills India, it would not have been so impactful when it comes to the students like me, like to get to know about this competition. So they have conducted around some 400 plus competitions all over India before they went ahead with the Nationals India Skill 2018. So yeah, that has definitely been one of the interesting things. So for the people to join. So this is where I have won the gold medal at the national competition. And so talking about the boot camp training that happened in Germany, these are some impressions from the boot camp training, wherein it was for around 2 weeks. And then after I was training for the competition at the Center of Excellence, these are a few impressions. And this is at the competition. So it is a 4-day competition. It was about 16 hours of the test projects that we were put into. So Water Technology had 5 modules, and the entire competition was intense. And on day one, actually, it was really challenging. So there was a kind of nervousness, and I was not completely feeling well. So I was a bit skeptical about how I'll be going, whether I'll be able to give my best or not. So my focus from day one has always been this, whether it was not about winning a medal, but about delivering the best at the competition, and also enhance my knowledge in this journey. That has been the key focus. And I was a bit skeptical about whether I'm going to perform well or not. But the task one, when I have completed my first task, and I didn't look at anyone when I was doing it. And at the end of the task, I was able to realize that I was the only one in the entire competition area to complete the task successfully. So that has given me a lot of boost. It has been a booster. Then after, I didn't look back, and I just continued performing in the best possible way. So it has been an incredible experience with the competition, and got to meet people from across the globe, and also with got to meet, interact people from best in the industry who have partnered with the skill. And this has actually helped to see more and all of the challenges that we are facing with the water industry. And after the 4-day competitions, the results were declared. It was really an intense moment, and one of those moments that I would cherish my entire life, winning the first gold medal for India. When it has been announced, the entire Indian contingent was on their feet, and everyone was really happy about this, because it has been quite long since we have been competing. And I have also been awarded the best of nation in the competition for the best performance from the country as well. So this is one moment that I would cherish my entire life. But what has been more overwhelming is the kind of appreciation that I received after winning the medal, and coming back to the country, and people have really appreciated this, and especially the students being more keen on joining this kind of platform or anything that is similar. But what matters is they were taking up a skill and trying to enhance their skill sets. And I have felt much happier when people came to me and told me that it has been inspiring, your journey has inspired us to do something in the area of interest. So that has been more overwhelming. And I have also been felicitated on various occasions by the state and central government, and also other organizations. So again, that has I would say it's really a proud moment to represent India at a world platform, and winning for the nation. I would say that it's more than something that I can express in words.
Yeah, Shweta. I think your story was very inspiring, and I think just learning about your journey has motivated me, and I'm sure it's motivated all of our audience as well. So I just have a quick question for you.
Sure.
So what was your one key takeaway from your journey? And if there was one summary from this journey, which, you know, really made an impact, and if there is there something that you really remember, or something that has left a lasting impression on you?
Yeah. So there are many such instances in the entire journey where things are there that I'll be remembering for a long time to come. But the most important one has been the entire learning that I have made. The knowledge that I have gained from this journey is going to stay with me. And that's the key takeaway, I would say. And whoever is competing or trying to do something on any platform, I would say that their focus should be on not winning or losing, but it should be on enhancing the knowledge and on what they are doing. That should be the key focus, and that's when the results are also in favor of us. But forgetting about the results, the knowledge is going to stay with us. So this is the key takeaway.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think as long as we put in 100%, we can all learn a lot. Thank you, Ashwata. Thank you so much for telling about your experiences. And it was we went along this journey with you as we were talking, and as it was very inspirational and very motivational. So thank you so much, and thank you for taking time to be.